Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to be doing the in-depth team guide, team building guide for the Super Saiyan 3 Bardock card. I do want to state, I am not going to be touching upon the Super Saiyan 3 Agility Bardock card just because there's going to be a lot to talk about here. I don't want it to ramble on too long, so I will be doing this in a separate video, so stay tuned for that. But I'm going to go ahead and talk about the Super Saiyan 3 Bardock Saiyan's Proof of Power. Now this is the new Super Saiyan 3 leader, category Super Saiyan 3, Ki plus 3, HP plus 130%, Attack and Defense plus 170%. This is such an amazing buff. The Reddit, I don't have the post up right now, but I know the Reddit had just posted, someone on the Reddit just posted the new information about the new hardest hitting units. And the newest hardest hitting units include the Super Saiyan 3 Bardock, the Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks, I believe, and the Super Saiyan 3 Agility Goku once you get him to level 140. That is insane. The top 10 hardest hitting list. So if you guys were lucky enough to pull him like I did, this team is just phenomenal. Unfortunately for me, I don't have the Fizz Tanks and I don't have the Agility Goku going up to level 140, but you could only do so much, right? But let's go ahead and jump into it. He also does Super Intelligence type, Ki plus 3, HP, Attack, and Defense plus 90%. So that does open up the door for a lot of other good cards, such as LR Gohan and Super Gogeta. This team is so overpowered, it's not even funny. His passive skill is Attack and Defense plus 100% up when performing a super attack, and when HP is 70% or below, super type allies get a 40% attack buff. So when your HP drops below 70%, you're doing 140% damage output for at least the card. Everyone else is getting an additional 40%. That also makes him, at 70% kind of stinks, but it does make him a decent passive for off rotation in case you're running something else, like we're going to talk about in a little bit. He has an amazing, amazing link skill set. Super Saiyan, experienced fighters, over in a flash, prepared for battle, fierce battle, limit breaking form, and the first awakened. He's part of two categories, Super Saiyan 3 and Revived Warrior. So that actually is really cool because he's part of the Revived Warrior. Because he's intelligence, unfortunately he's super, but you can still use him on the Agility Super Saiyan 3 at Goku event to get him to level 140. It looks like the wiki actually started changing things up in terms of max stats. So max stats are going to be 11,020 for HP, attack of 10,728, and defense of 5,955. That is actually a really high defense buff, all things considering. Max base dupe system, 13,000 attack, 13,000 HP, 12,700 attack, and he has about almost 8,000 defense. That's just insane. And then if you go all the way and let's say you pulled all the dupes of him, 16,000 total HP, 15,700 attack, and 10,955 defense. This guy is insane, and he has a 12 key multiplier of 150%. I'm very happy I got him. I have him up at Super Attack 6 right now. I really want to get him up to Super Attack 10. Unfortunately, I'm not going to be grinding those out. I used all those other cards or the Super Saiyan Bardock cards, and I put them all into one so I can get him up to Super Attack 10 before I Dokken Awaken him. Probably should have grinded him out since I'm free to play, but it's alright. At least on the JP side. This card is phenomenal. He hits very hard. He defends very, very well. And because of that attack and defense buff of 170% for Super Saiyan 3 types or category type, he's just an amazing card. So we have a lot to talk about here. So first off, we're going to go ahead. I'm just going to drag this over real quick. Hopefully you can see everything. I know it's a little bit off. Let's do this. Alright, cool. So it's a little bit better to see. This is all the Super Saiyan 3s that are available in game at this point in time. As you can see here, we have the Bardock leaders. All of these are, it's either one or the other. You can't choose the agility and the intelligence to be on the same team. The same thing with a lot of these cards. A lot of these cards are duplicates, like the Super Saiyan 3 Goku's over here, the Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta with the physical or the strength Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta. A lot of these guys cannot be thrown on the same team. I believe it's a total of 14 unique units. The teams that I'm going to be talking about are going to be unique units and the hard-hitting ones. I may mention some of the SSR variants, but I probably won't be doing too much about. I definitely won't be doing too much about them. On top of that, you can go over here. By the way, shout out to DBZ.Space for this information. These are all of the units that are super intelligence type. We're going to be using some of these as well. I'm sorry if some of you are getting to get upset because I'm not going to mention every single unit that is viable here. I'm just talking about the most viable in my opinion. And viable is to mean cards that will allow for the most damage output within a time and have good like passive skills like defensive or attack buffs or attacks for all allies, stuff like that. Attack increases, key increases, chances to dodge, anything like that. That's usually what that means. Without further ado, let's go ahead and talk about it. First off, in-game, This is every single card that he links very, very well with. As you can see, everyone is four or more. I couldn't do five because there's only one card that links with five, and we're going to talk about that in a second. But on the left-hand side are all the Super Saiyan 3s. On the bottom are kind of like cards that are just like there that you may want to, you may run on a team, but they're not going to primarily run on a team. And then the ones on the right are just going to be cards that are really good units depending on the team. Like a hero team, you're going to want to run the Vegito Blue, or you may run the Kaioken Blue Goku, or the Strength Gogeta. Now, his best linking buddy in-game happens to be the Intelligence Gogeta card. That's actually really awesome because he is a phenomenal unit and he's Intelligence. So if you have both of them, you may want to consider running that Super Gogeta on your Super Saiyan 3 team just because of the damage output. I just found this out. I just realized that when I was doing the team building guide, and I've been running my Super Saiyan 3 Bardock team. Well, he's not Dokken yet, but I've been running it without him. I'm probably going to go ahead and throw him on once he gets Dokken Awakening, because that's just going to make him make the team that much better. So his best linking buddy is that Super Gogeta. On the left-hand side, as you see, four link skills with every single one of the Super Saiyans. Now, he doesn't hit off all the same links, but there's just too many of them, so I'm not going to go all over every single one. In terms of the link skills, I'll tell you the most common ones are going to be Over in a Flash, Fierce Battle, Limit Breaking Form. Those are the three most common. Oh, and Super Saiyan, obviously. So those are really the four that most of these guys are going to have. Some of them, probably like the Vegeta, won't have Over in a Flash, unfortunately, but you know, there's nothing you can really do about that. The card wasn't like gifted with that, if you will. So let's go ahead and talk about it over here. In terms of Mono Intelligence, these are all the best Mono Intelligence that he links with for three or more. So as you see, the Gogeta, he already stands out. The Super Saiyan 3 Gohan from the Dragon Ball Heroes banner, if you guys were lucky enough to go ahead and get that, he does link for four with him. LR Gohan does share three link skills with him, so I know a lot of you may have been wondering about that for the Mono Intelligence. LR Gohan is actually a viable option to run. So honestly, even though he's meant for Super Saiyan 3s, if you're looking more for Mono Intelligence, his team build for Mono Intelligence seems a little bit better just because he does do those buffs for those Intelligence units. He does Super Saiyan, Prepared for Battle, and Fierce Battle with the LR Gohan, which is a 25% attack buff. So these two will be doing a lot of good benefit to each other. Top of that, Ultra Instinct Goku matches for three with him, so does the Intelligence Vegeta. This Goku, the orb-changing Goku, he's not like a top-tier unit, but he's good because he's an orb manipulator for LR Gohan if you have him. I don't know why I have you here, we don't need you. We have the TUR variant of Gohan. We have the Trunks, I'll talk about that Goku actually. Oh no, they're the same Goku. We took out the SSR variant, and then this is the free-to-play Trunks who does link with him as well. If you don't have anyone else to really link with him, I'm not going to say his primary unit you're going to want to do that with, but you can do that with a Super Saiyan Trunks. I don't know why, but you can. we'll take him off of there. Anyway, with that being said, this is all the Super Saiyan 3s that are available. At least the ones that I think are really good. Obviously, the Super Saiyan 3 Gokus that are all over here. I think this is actually the kid version, so it's not too big. Yeah, this is the kid version that Dokken Awakened, the GT one. Again, really upset he didn't get Saiyan Roar. Anyway, then we also have the Angel Goku, the Super Saiyan 3 Gohan, the Super Saiyan 3 Trunks, the Super Saiyan 3 Goku, the free-to-play one. We have the Gotenkses over here, the physical and the technique one, the adult Gotenks who links very well. All these guys are just phenomenal. The other Super Saiyan 3 Great Ape Goku, now this one's going to be a staple unit in this team in my opinion, just because of that attack buff he gives to everyone. You do have the Vegetas over here. These two can't be run on the same team, but honestly, I think that this Vegeta over here, even though he doesn't attack very well, because he has that passive that reduces damage, he's going to come into play very much on this team because of that to help tank. Because if you notice, all the Super Saiyan 3s, Vegeta is really, well, Vegeta and Trunks, technically, because Trunks is the only, he only has one really Super Saiyan 3 card. They're really good with defensive purposes, that's it. But no one has any type of, like, HP regeneration or anyone, no one else really has good defensive capabilities. So you will really be relying on the Vegeta and the Trunks for the team building. Gotenks does have a higher defensive stat, and so does the Bardock, especially with the buffs from Bardock's leader ability, so you won't have to worry too much. But still, because there's not a lot of healing going on here, not a lot of people who can tank a lot of damage, you want to really utilize those guys. But in terms of for damage output, let's go ahead and talk about it. So over here we have the first team build that I have come up with. This is purely for Super Saiyan 3 team building. Let's actually go here. I'm going to go ahead and zoom in on this one because this is going to really be what you guys are going to look for your team building guide. All right, there's that, and then we're gonna move this up, and the graph, perfect. All right, cool. So as we see over here, we have the Super Saiyan 3 Agility Goku. Now, he only fits on this team if you are able to get him to level 140. That's the only time I'm going to recommend having him. Other than that, I mean, if you don't have anyone else, yes, run him. I do run him on my team. But the thing is, with the current attack buffs that he's getting, he is not hitting as hard as I would like him to. Again, my Super Saiyan 3 Bardock is not Dokkan Awakened, so I can't really attest too much. I will do a gameplay video of him with... I have my actual Super Saiyan 3 Goku. There's no dupe system fed in. He's at Super Attack 1, and he's at level 125. So for like newer players, you may be able to relate more to my situation, so I'll do a gameplay video with him so that we can see how much attack damage he does have. But he is a good linking buddy if you have him fully maxed out. He shares 4 link skills with the Bardock, which is going to be Super Saiyan, Over and a Flash, Fierce Battle, and Going Beyond the Limit. Now, honestly, Going Beyond the Limit, or whatever the heck the actual global name is not really that good. You shouldn't take that in consideration when you're talking about team builds, because it's a flat-out buff. With all this percentage increases, that 2,000 attack buff really doesn't do anything. So really, we're looking at the 25% attack buff and key plus 3. Very good link skill set. The next good setup that you could have running together, if you have them, is going to be the Super Saiyan 3 Fizz Tanks with the Super Saiyan 3 Fizz Tanks, you know, the adult version. They share 6 link skills together, and I know we've talked about this on multiple videos, but they share 6 link skills together. They're sharing, 15, 25, 35% attack, and they're giving each other 5 key. So plus, you know, obviously the flat out boost. So that's really good. The thing that stinks is obviously your Fizz Tanks is over here. You're going to want him to get a full 11 key. That won't happen with this. By the way, if I think I called him Fizz Tanks over here, he's not Fizz Tanks, he's God Tanks, or adult God Tanks anyway, so I apologize about that. But he's not gonna be able to get off his 11 key super, which you're gonna want with having them linked together, but their attack damage is gonna make up for that, in my opinion, other than not having it. I mean, I guess you could technically run the Bardock over here on Dokkan Awakened. It'll help you out. You only need to get 1 key orb, but you know, take it for what you will. I don't think you're going to want to do that, but he's really good setup. Now, if you don't have these two, or if you don't have this guy over here, or one of these two, another good setup is a Super Saiyan 3 Angel Goku and this Vegeta. Personally, I think you should still have this Vegeta on your team regardless, just because he is good at tanking damage. The Super Saiyan 3 Trunks, and we'll talk about him and this Vegeta in a little bit, but he is really good. He also links very well to Super Saiyan 3 Goku, the Angel Goku. They share 5 link skills, including Super Fierce Battle, which is Golden Warrior for key plus 1 to enemy, defense minus 2,000, which isn't really talked about too much. It's really not that great. Super Saiyan for 10%. Super excited. So that's 25% attack buff, key plus 3, because he does have a short Over and a Flash, and the flat out attack buff. So they're sharing 4 key link together and a 25% attack buff. They're really good link skills or linking buddies. And again, this Vegeta is going to tank a lot of damage, so I would recommend having these two run together. Now, again, this is just what I'm thinking about for an optimal Super Saiyan 3 team. You can also have these guys down here. This Trunks and this Vegeta notably will do a lot more tanking, better tanking than anyone else because of their passive skills. They do increase their own defense. This Gohan is also a very notable unit because he's an intelligence Super Saiyan 3. He does hit pretty hard. I do run him on my mono intelligence team. Unfortunately, he's only Super Attack 1 with no dupe system I put into him. But he is hitting for, I think, about 300,000 damage, maybe 400,000 on a mono intelligence Gogeta team. So he does do some decent damage. So if you get him up to Super Attack 10 and if you start throwing some dupe system, he's going to do a lot more damage. These three are really good switch-in units if you don't have any of the OP units over here, or if you just want to have fun. Personally, I like them, so I'm running them. But again, I don't have a lot of these units over here. I have the Technique Fizz Tanks, the Technique God Tanks. I need to stop saying that. Now, on rotation with this team, if you're going to go up with one of these builds, obviously you're going to want the Super Saiyan 3 Bardock over here. You can link him with whoever you want, but after you figure out which of your prime rotations are going to be, including any of these are going to be your choices. Well, you really only have 2 choices out of here, 2 out of the 3, because the other Super Saiyan 3 Bardock friend's going to be off rotation. He's going to be switching on and off because of this is how you're going to set up is going to be, and then you have a choice between these guys. So you can choose, personally, obviously Super Saiyan 3 Goku is going to be a primary that you're going to want because he does get that additional HP attack and defense buff. Even though he's supposed to be a support unit, he's going to be giving everyone the additional buffs from his passive skill. On top of that, he does get the extended ability for being on the Super Saiyan 3 team. Now, outside of that, it's your choice between Whis and Pandel. Personally, I would recommend running Pandel just because she gives better buffs. Whis does do the key buff on his passive, but you don't really need it because everyone here pretty much, yeah, I think, yeah, everyone here shares over in a flash. So you don't need that key. Whis is cool though because if you don't have Pandel, he does do the attack and defense, I believe, plus 25%. So that's really worth it. So it's really honestly up to you guys how you want to run it. Now you can keep your Bardock on primary rotation over here and have all three of them and just select like one guy, like do it like this maybe. Have both your Bardocks, your Bardock and your friend Bardock, and then you have Super Saiyan 3 Goku, Super Saiyan 3 Fizz Tanks on your rotation, and you could throw Whis in there so that way you have three support units over there. But it's really up to you. I don't know how you would want to do that. I think that the damage output that would be lost by the buffs from a support unit would be gained by having Super Saiyan 3 Bardock. So I would do something like this. Like, in my opinion, my best team, my most optimal team that I could think for Super Saiyan 3s would be this setup over here. The only one who's not getting the Super Saiyan 3 buff is Pandel, but she is a super intelligence unit, so she will be getting the HP attack and defense of 90%, which is not that bad. You know, you lose a little bit, but you gain that attack, the attack and defense buff from her. So yeah, that's the Super Saiyan 3 build, guys. In my opinion, I think this is going to be the best one that you can do. It depends on who you have over here, but you know, take it for what you need. Different reasons, you bring different people in for different reasons. If you're going up against, let's say, a technique team, you may not want to run this the Fizz Tanks over here. An agility team, you may want to do the Fizz Tanks. You might want to bring the Super Saiyan 3 Goku so we have more agility unit or technique units on there. Play it for how you need it. Now, last but not least, we're just going to talk about Mono Intelligence over here. These units can also be run on the Super Saiyan 3 Bardock team. I don't recommend doing it because you are probably, well, you can, but I don't recommend making your primary choices. Now, this is why. First off, this is going to be more for Super Saiyan Gogeta team or Super Gogeta team intelligence. They link very well. They're each other's best link. Well, Super Saiyan 3 Bardock's his best linking, but I actually didn't check to see who Super Gogeta's is. It might be Bardock. But they share 5 link skills for attack plus 35% up, key plus 5, so they're always going to be getting their supers off, which makes it very, very viable. On top of that, you also have the LR Gohan, which I mentioned before earlier. They share the 3 link skills, which is Super Saiyan, Prepared for Battle, and Fierce Battle. So that's an additional 25% attack and 2 key. And then on the rotation, you do have choices. Now, personally, I think your best choices are going to be Pandel and Gohan, and then you have a choice between like Buff Ku or Whis. Honestly, it doesn't matter between the two of them, just choose who you want. Off rotation, other people that you can choose for this team would be either the Trunks, Vegeta, or the Super Saiyan 3 Gohan. Outside of that, this is going to be your best Mono Intelligence team that you can run with Bardock in mind. I know I have two over here, so that's if you bring this on your team and you bring a Super Saiyan 3 Bardock. If you bring like a Super Gogeta and a super, like, there we go, let's do it like this. So we have Super Gogeta, this is your Super Gogeta, this is your Bardock who you have on the team. Then you bring a friend over here, you might want to consider swapping out this Super Saiyan 3 Gohan for someone else. I know you would not definitely wouldn't want to swap him out for LR Gohan, but it will help out with the HP buff, so you could throw him on rotation and take like Whis or Buff Ku out. That might help you out because you're getting the additional attack and defense buff from on that Super Saiyan 3 Gohan. He'll do some nice damage output. On top of that, he just does a lot of damage output, and he links well with the Super Saiyan 3 Bardock, so you can keep Super Saiyan 3 Bardock in the middle to have that additional link skills to make sure everything else goes the way you want it to. Again, you don't need to do it that way, you can do it that way. With that being said, on top of this, all these units can be thrown in the Super Saiyan 3 team. Like, again, not something I would primarily recommend. If you wanted to do it, you can literally take Super Saiyan 3 Bardock, Super Gogeta, put them on one rotation. You take the LR Gohan, throw them on there with another Bardock, and instead of having three support units, you can go back over here and take like the Agility Goku and the Fizz Tanks and the Super Saiyan 3 Angel Goku, and you just have a ridiculously hard-hitting team. That would be a phenomenal amount of damage. I actually would like to see that being done, just to see how much damage output they can do. But yeah, guys, that's it. That's the team building guide. Let me know if that helped you out. Let me know if you have any recommendations, if I missed anything, if I didn't cover something you didn't like. I did my best to try and build this. I honestly haven't checked out the Reddit to see if anyone else had any other ideas, but right now I think we have a really good leader. The Super Saiyan 3 Bardock, the way he was built, it just makes that Mono Intelligence come back and kick everyone in the butt. But anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today. Make sure to subscribe if you're new. Stay tuned because, again, I will be doing the Super Saiyan 3 Agility Bardock team building guide probably tomorrow. Thank you. I'll catch you all later. Peace.